Hello everyone, hi, welcome to the channel of Wall Street Mojo.
Watch the video till the end, and also if you are new to this channel, then you can subscribe us by clicking the bell icon.
Friends, today we are going to learn a tutorial on Nopat versus net income. Nopat is basically your net operating profit after tax. So let's get into this, what exactly we are going to discuss over here. See, if you are an investor, you have two options. You can look at the net income as every investor does, or you can become wise and check both the net income and the NOPAT, that is your net operating profit after tax, right? So how does this net operating profit after tax has been calculated? The net income first, the net income is calculated by deducting all the expenses incurred during the year, and that includes all the non-cash expenses, that includes your depreciation also. So, your net income includes all the expenses, that includes non-cash. But if we talk about NOPAT over here, NOPAT on the other hand is calculated by using operating income. This is really very important. Now, how a business is doing operationally can be described better by NOPAT than the net income. Even if there is a key difference between net income and NOPAT, looking at each of them would give the investor the clarity that they need to decide whether to invest in a company or not. So in this particular tutorial, we are going to look at top differences between NOPAT versus net income and why you as an investor should care. So let's discuss this difference between the NOPAT and net income. The first and the foremost thing, as you can see, NOPAT is calculated on operating income, that is, all those which are non-recurring in nature won't be included in this, to find out the operating efficiency of the company. Net income, however, is calculated by deducting all the expenses, that includes your non-cash expenditures, non-cash revenues, so it can be anything. Now, the second, so the first was the inherent meaning. The second that we are going to discuss is the application of the same. Over here, NOPAT is used to understand the operational efficiency. Over here, it was operating efficiency of the company, operational efficiency without the leverage. That is, we are not going to include the interest portion. So, net operating profit after tax. So, interest without the leverage. Net income is the most common measure of profitability of the company. After deducting everything, you get your net income. Is interest expense deducted? No. That's why it has been said over here, operational efficiency without leverage, and over here, with leverage. So that's why no interest is deducted over here. And yes, interest is deducted. Net income is after everything. Tax, all the operating expenses, income. Let it be tax, let it be interest, let it be depreciation. Everything is deducted, and then after you get your net income. The next difference, importance. NOPAT doesn't take interest expense on debt into account. So that's what we discussed above. So the importance is that the interest expense is not taken into consideration. So we will be able to see the DSCR ratio over here. We'll be able to analyze for the debt holders, that how far the company will be able to repay the principal plus interest. So NOPAT doesn't take interest expense on debt into account. Net income is deducted by deducting every possible expense from the revenue. Now, specific use. NOPAT is used for the investors. And over here, net income is like for everyone. It's like, come, everyone is invited over here. It's like shareholders, investors, external stakeholders, and so on and so forth. But NOPAT is specifically useful for the investors. Now, how it has been calculated? If you see NOPAT, NOPAT is calculated by the operating income, that is your earning before interest and tax, into 1 minus tax. That means you are basically doing a post-tax operating income. So, net operating profit after tax, but interest is not deducted. So operating income is what you're earning before interest and tax, and post that you are just multiplying 1 minus tax, that is your post tax income, without deducting interest, that is your NOPAT. Your net income is your net profit less the interest expense, less the taxes. So net profit, this is your, let's say this is your earning before interest and tax. So if you deduct interest, you get earning before tax, that is your EBT. If you deduct tax, then you get earning after tax, that is your PAT or EAT. And then you deduct dividend paid to the preference shareholders. Post that, if there is dividend that is paid to equity shareholders, then that is net income. Now, used to compare the performances between the two firms, usually the firms do that. And over here, to evaluate the overall company's performances. Now, does take leverage into account? No. We have already understood, yes. No interest, yes interest. Now, let's understand the key differences in NOPAT versus net income. See, there are many differences between NOPAT and net income. But let's have a look at the key differences. See, NOPAT, as we know that, is a measure of what? Operating efficiency. We now know very well. For the investor, if investor know that net income, they can ascertain NOPAT easily. But if they know NOPAT to ascertain net income, they need not to know the interest rate on the debt. Second, while computing the NOPAT, interest expense on debt are not deducted. While asserting net income, interest expense on debt are deducted. If you talk about NOPAT, NOPAT helps the investors make comparison among the firms on operating efficiency. Net income helps the investors get profitability ratios of the firms. But having a glance at net income does not create value, since to find out net income, even non-cash expenses like depreciation is also deducted. So that was your third point. The fourth one, in case of NOPAT, the actual sales over here, I mean to say, the actual tax expenses are calculated. But in net income, the tax expenses get significantly reduced due to the effect of the leverage. Now, looking at the one ratio will not offer the investor sufficiently. So, each investor should look at both the NOPAT and the net income to get the idea of the profitability, actual taxes to be paid, interest expense on debt, and the effect on the leverage on the profitability. So, you can say calculating the NOPAT is no brainer. On the other hand, ascertaining net income needs a bit more time and calculation. So, after learning this, we can make a final conclusion that as an investor, it's wise to not become a one-eyed deer. You will gain much more insight into a company when you look at all the aspects of the profitability of the company. So first, you should look at all the four financial statements. Then you should look at the net income, NOPAT, net cash inflows and outflows, net revenues, return on total assets, return on equity, and return on capital invested, and so on and so forth.
So that's it for this particular topic. If you have learned and enjoyed watching this video, please like and comment on this video and subscribe to our channel for the latest updates. Thank you, everyone. Cheers.